this is where we start to flesh out Aragorn's character. Because, you know, at this point in time, you've only known him as Strider, a fairly enigmatic ranger. But, you know, Aragorn has this very complex sort of psychological story, really. Well, we've made it more complex in the sense of what is actually in the books, of the fact that he is the heir to the throne of Gondor, the broken sword, which I didn't want to introduce in Bree being pulled out of the scabbard. So this is the way that we decided to present the sword. Alan Lee.
In the video camera, it looks so weird. It looks just like a line. Like here.
Video tape?
Yeah.
Like, take the thing,
put it on there. Yeah, and his relationship with Aragorn was stretched out slightly more in the original footage that we shot. We trimmed it back and looked at the version. But we just had this little piece of dialogue between the two. When we were making our decisions about what to include in the film, we felt that the scene in the council where Boromir and Aragorn had their little confrontation was a strong enough scene to be the first time that we see the two of them interact together. But we had already shot this, which was very nice. I mean, it's really evocative. There's nothing at all wrong with it. We just felt that there was a slight piece of redundancy since they do have a moment together later in the council. We really wanted to create a nice story between Boromir and Aragorn, because really from this point on to the end of the film, the relationship between Boromir and Aragorn becomes one of our central pieces of dramatic structure, really.